Abernathy Fish Technology Center is located along the Columbia River near Longview, Washington. We are probably one of the few research facilities in the world that has the opportunity to study organisms in laboratory settings, within a hatchery setting, and we also have a stream setting. We can study fish and other aquatic organisms in their natural habitat. We started out producing Chinook salmon, slowly developed into a research facility doing salmon culture and nutrition research, and moved into conservation genetics with a tiny little lab. We now have a large, very complex genetics lab. We have ecological physiology, which merges science of the laboratory with science of the creek. And now we have a new program, which is modeling.
The program is about modeling, but it's really developing models, thinking about problems, providing solutions to tangible problems. One of the first major efforts that I anticipate will be to develop decision support models to help integrate climate change data. A lot of the data that is becoming available are on a global scale, global climate models, global circulation models, but that's at a much larger scale in many cases than biologists and conservation planners are making decisions.
Ken Ostrand, the head of the Ecological Physiology Program here at Abernathy. The Ecological Physiology Program integrates the fields of physiology and fishery science and incorporates electronic technology to answer ecological questions. The physiology program is very similar to getting a physical exam at a doctor's office where they take blood or tissue, do some analysis, and they give you back a sheet of paper that has various numbers of different biochemical constituents. We do the same thing with fish, except we use those numbers then to associate that with, did that habitat enhance the fish's biochemistry and therefore impart a benefit to that fish? The fishery science component is going out and looking at the demographics of fish populations. How fast are the fish growing? How fast are they migrating? How are they behaving and interacting with other fish species? We take the physiological data and the fishery science data. We combine that to try to discover a particular mechanism why a population may be increasing or decreasing or simply not growing at proper rates or reproducing at proper rates. We incorporate our electronics technology into that to monitor fish populations. The electronic technology uses passive integrated transponders primarily, which are small glass tags. Those small glass tags we implant inside internally in the fish, and they stay within the fish until they're adults. And we're able then to track individual fish through time.
I'm Denise Hawkins. I'm the Region 1 regional geneticist and head of the Conservation Genetics Program here at Abernathy Fish Technology Center. We currently have 7 full-time staff, and we process about 10,000 samples every year. The program, the Conservation Genetics Program here at Abernathy, has a fairly wide variety of projects. And so our role in the projects that are ongoing here at Abernathy and with our other collaborators is to provide genetic information to help them make decisions. One of the projects that we're currently working on here in the Conservation Genetics Program at Abernathy is our Relative Reproductive Success Project. This particular project works with steelhead here in Abernathy Creek, and we're looking at the success of both hatchery origin and natural origin fish that are spawning naturally here in Abernathy Creek. Another use for the genetic information that's produced by the program here at Abernathy is in listing and delisting decisions. We can provide information on the distinctness of different populations, and this information can then be used in determining how to group these populations for recovery units and whether or not a particular population is in need of protection through the Endangered Species Act. Another type of project that we're involved with here at Abernathy is what we call real-time rapid response genetic identification. In this case, samples are shipped to us overnight from our collaborators in the field. We then take those tissue samples from those fish and provide genetic information that they can then use for management decisions.
I'm Ann Ganim, and I work here at the Abernathy Fish Technology Center in the Fish Nutrition Program. One of the main objectives of our program is to provide good feed for the hatcheries in Region 1 and Region 8. One thing that we do here is fish feed quality control. We get samples from all of our hatcheries once a quarter, and we check them for protein lipid, moisture, and ash. We call that proximate analysis of the feed. At Abernathy, we're fortunate enough to have this single screw extruder, a Wanger X85, and we can make small batches of experimental diets on this machine. We have requests often for other experimental diets from either USGS or universities because feed mills can't make the small batches that we can. It's very important to have a complete diet for the fish because our fish are held in raceways and there's no other way to get their nutrition. Since one of the areas of fish nutrition that I'm really interested in is nutrition and fish health, another special diet that we developed was testing beta-glucans in the feed. And beta-glucans are known to be an immunostimulant. And so if we could enhance the immune system of the fish before they were stressed, we could get away from having to use a lot of antibiotics.
Our future research includes, obviously, exploring fish that are recently listed. Future research also includes preventing the listing of species, such as the Pacific lamprey. Our primary focus and goal, of course, still relates back to hatcheries and trying to maximize the use of hatchery fish, both for conservation needs and for all of our other trusts.
Thank you very much for coming to Abernathy Fish Technology Center. We hope you've enjoyed your tour. Please visit us sometime.